lovelies, it's me, Simply Cherie, making home and entertaining simple.
Our family meals for the week, Tuscan Tortellini Salad.
For the prosciutto, I actually can just rip it apart like that. But if you want a cleaner cut, obviously use a knife. I'm just gonna cut the salami into like quarters because I want them to be bite-sized pieces. And when I toss in the tortellini, I'm going to make sure that it's cooled down before putting it in because you don't want the spinach to be cooked.
Okay, I know it looks like a lot of meat, but remember we're gonna be putting a pound of that tortellini and then some spinach.
I love tomatoes. I used to eat tomatoes like fruit by themselves.
Oh, I was just corrected by my daughter. Tomatoes are fruit. Yes, that's right, because they have seed in them. You can always add more spinach if you want. So I toss it a little bit, add some cheese, and then toss it again so that the cheese will be mixed in there. Once I've tossed everything, I add a little bit more of the cheese, and then this is a three-seed bread, and then some Kerrygold butter. And we are ready to eat.
Hi friends, it's Wednesday. I'm making Crock-pot tomato soup today with grilled cheese sandwiches. The ingredients for tomato soup are right over here. The crock pot there. I'm going to set that up so that it cooks during the day and assemble the grilled cheese sandwiches. And then right before we eat dinner, I'm just going to grill them up. These are the ingredients. It is, of course, canned tomatoes. I use these stewed Italian style. Couple stalks of this celery. This I add to the recipe. 2 cups of veggie broth. That is one. And then two. All the ingredients are in the crock pot. I always get sourdough bread, provolone, and Colby Jack. 3 fit in this container, so that's for dinner tonight. If they want extras, I have this container. I do have some cheese left, so I do want to make some extras. This is great for like after school. It's already prepped, and I just have to grill it up for Sicily. It's been about 3 hours. I'm just going to stir this up and cook it on low for at least another 3. I scooped it out, put it into the blender and pureed it, and then put it back in the crock pots. Okay, so this is our dinner for Wednesday night. Hi lovelies, it's Friday. Last night, Thursday, we just had leftovers. I'm making for our Bible study group tonight because we are having a potluck. Here is shrimp, I'm just gonna use half of that. And then this is the galangal, which is kind of like ginger. I'll put a link to the grocery haul where it explains a little bit of what that is. These are lime leaves, chilies, 8 cloves of garlic, mushroom. This is Thai chili paste, 4 stalks of lemongrass, 2 onions, 4 to 5 limes. I'm gonna use 4 in the recipe and then cut up 1 as like lime that you can squeeze into the soup right before you eat it. It says 3 tomatoes, so this is what I have. And then a handful of cilantro. Everything is chopped up and prepared. The shrimp is peeled and deveined, and I put a little bit of salt. The recipe does call for fish sauce and some sugar, some salt. The tom yum soup is cooking. I've got their mushrooms, tomatoes, onions, garlic, lime leaves. Once this is cooking for another minute and a half, I'm gonna add the shrimp and then add the cilantro. I've turned it off only because I don't want the shrimp to overcook. You could see the shrimp cooking right away. So that is tom yum soup with shrimp. That's our dinner for Friday night. I am making veggie pot pie. This is really easy. Here is the pie pan, and I get whatever pie crusts are on sale that week. I put a little bit of cooking spray here. I got some flour, milk, veggie broth. This is salt, garlic powder. It calls for fennel, thyme, stuff like that, but this is what I have. And I'm using ground pepper. Here are the veggies, broccoli, cauliflower, frozen peas. I also have carrots. I'm gonna use half of this onion, and then I have potatoes. The box actually has 2 pie crusts, so I went ahead and sprayed this, put the pie crust on there, and then the other one, I just leave it on a plate till I'm ready to cover it. Now all I have to do is saute the vegetables, the onions first, and now I'm sauteing the vegetables, vegetable broth, milk, and flour. See how it gets nice and creamy? That's what you want. So I just cook this kind of like
halfway through because it's gonna cook more when I put it in the pie crust. And I actually cook the pot pie in my toaster oven because it's big enough and it saves on energy versus using a whole big oven.
I'm not the type's gotta have someone. I'm not the type's gotta be in love. I had a lot of people come and go. And plus anyway, I'm used to being solo. But it was good when you came to me. You were the one to make me believe that life could be better, that we can get back together. Come.
I cooked the veggie pot pie at 400 degrees for 30 minutes. That's the server there. And I put it on a plate just to protect the placemat. It's so simple and easy, and I actually don't serve anything else with it because I've already got the pie crust and the vegetables, and it's pretty much a meal in itself. The last meal I'll be cooking for a week of family meals is a Mongolian beef, and I'm serving it with a side of asparagus and rice. I've already cut the beef, so this is the one I'm going to use for tonight, and then this will be extra, so I'm going to just have that marinate. Okay, you're supposed to cook the sauce separately, so I've mixed it all in. The soy sauce, brown sugar, cornstarch, then I put a little bit of oil, the garlic, and the ginger. Then we cook the sauce until it thickens. This is what the sauce looks like 5 minutes in. Cut and prepped the asparagus, and then I just put salt and pepper. So for the last 5 minutes that the sauce is cooking, I went ahead and started the rice. This is what the sauce looks like after 10 minutes. It's kind of syrupy because of the brown sugar. The recipe asked for cornstarch, but I'm out of that, so I put it in flour. While that was sitting, I went ahead and did the dishes and put all the food away. So it says to cook for 2 to 3 minutes until the meat is crispy. I added a little bit more oil so you can see that it's frying up really nicely. It's been 3 minutes, so I'm just gonna flip them over so you can see it's crispy like that. So I actually forgot a half cup of water in it, so I put it in now. I added another whole cup and a half of water, and I like it better this way. I think it's because I use flour instead of cornstarch. I'm going to add the green onions, some red chili flakes. Dinner is served with the asparagus. I just added some fried red onions that comes from the Asian store. Here is the jasmine rice. And then the Mongolian beef, I added a few more green onions on top. I hope you enjoyed this video of our weekly family meals for this week. If you're new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button. I'd love to have you on this journey with me to making home and entertaining simple. And for those of you who've been loyal subscribers, thanks so much. Let me know what you think about these meals I've done this week, and if you have done any new recipes in this past month. Okay, see you guys in the next one. Bye.
I'm waiting long for you, so be my princess for life.